My name is Tori Stromp. I'm a second year graduate student at the University of Kentucky, and I work within the SAHA Cardiovascular Research Center and with the Gill Heart Institute. And our lab is working on developing some new MRI techniques to image hearts in a variety of different patients. So in normal cardiac MRI, they have to use contrast agents and they have to be injected. Those can be really dangerous for some people, specifically people who have renal problems or problems with their kidneys. So I have the pleasure of working with those exact patients and using our new technique that does not involve any contrast agents in order to identify changes in their hearts. My dad was a scientist. And he's always pushed us to be smarter and to ask questions and to really look into the details of how things work. And he went more of the biology route, and I was a little more drawn towards the medicine route. But I think that kind of drive in our family to always question things really helped me become a scientist. Interestingly, my mom is a musician, and I turned into a dancer because of that. But I kind of got the background of being a choreographer through that, and it kind of solidified my place as being backstage. I loved being backstage and really influencing kind of the end product. So combining those two really made me realize that being a researcher was a good way to influence medicine and doctors without being one myself. Actually, our lab is really unique that we have a wide variety of backgrounds that come in, and really everyone brings their own skill set that helps all of us really succeed. You know, we really have built a strong team that, you know, we can pick each other up where we have weaknesses, but we also really get to shine on our own strengths as well. My typical day doing research starts with acquiring MRI images from patients that we've recruited to be in our studies. I work within the Gill Imaging Center on their clinical scanner, and I'm fortunate to have been trained really well in actually acquiring the images on that scanner. Everybody's heart is different, which makes it a challenge, but it also helps us really hone in on what we're looking for and how we can measure it, because if this is a technology that we're trying to push into the clinics one day, it needs to be able to work in everybody's heart. And it makes it a challenge to look at different hearts every single day and really see what's going on, but I think it helps keep our technology really meaningful, because that's the exact kind of people that we want it to be used in later on. For a person interested in doing this kind of work, I would suggest looking for opportunities anywhere that you can find them. Researchers love to talk about their science, so the first thing you should do is ask. We all love spreading the word about what we're doing, and we all love the help. Research is very hard work, so people coming in and volunteering their time is really important. And so if you're interested in doing the science that we do, ask around, see if there are any opportunities to, you know, look at a lab, volunteer in the lab, and just become part of the science and see where it takes you.